I'm not sure what led me to watch this show. Could it have been a case of divine intervention? A celestial being climbing from the depths to convince me to watch a cartoon? Or perhaps it was just a Crunchyroll Twitter account sending me subliminal messages again. Truly, there'd be no way of knowing. For the most part, I don't just jump into an anime without some context. I know what I like. I like shonen. Maybe throw in a sports series or two. Some cute girls doing cute things. A little slice of life. The occasional rom-com. I rarely go off the beaten path. I don't tend to stray too far from what I know, and I certainly am not a fan of psychological horror and things of that nature. Which isn't an issue because Don't Toy With Me Nagatoro is very clearly just a typical high school slice-of-life rom-com, right? Well, no. That's why I made a video. Me watching this show was completely by accident. I meant to click for laid-back camp on Crunchyroll, yet ended up with whatever Nagatoro is. Why did I stay? I'm not sure. Maybe it's because from the moment it began, the show made me feel so uncomfortable that if I didn't stay, it would punish me for it. Yeah, that's it. Discomfort is definitely the best way to describe what this show is doing to me. I don't know what happens in the manga, but from what I've seen in the anime so far, Nagatoro is a goddamn psychopath. The whole concept of Don't Toy With Me Nagatoro is that Nagatoro, a freshman and massive a-hole, meets an upperclassman only known thus far as Senpai. Let me rephrase that. She doesn't really meet him. She sees him in the library and then decides to spend the rest of her life sadistically brutalizing him. I haven't really seen any of the Saw movies, but I can't imagine they're too different than episode 1 of this show. I saw a trailer for the new one with Chris Rock when I saw the Demon Slayer movie, and there were way too many similarities between it and Nagatoro. I mean, just look at Chris Rock and Nagatoro. They both just look so empty. Though, more than Nagatoro being a modern-day Chris Rock, I'm mainly focused on the whole torture simulation that seems to go into every episode of this show. In episode 1 alone, Nagatoro makes a grown man cry twice with her psychological warfare, within a 20-minute time frame. I mean, she lives for this. It's almost like torturing Senpai is what sustains her very being. I mean, look at this. She's skipping away gleefully as Senpai laments his fate. She's in pure bliss over the pain she has caused. Nagatoro is an absolute menace and nobody can stop her. I've never read any of Junji Ito's manga. Quite frankly, the covers alone scare me enough. But Ito has nothing on Nagatoro. Nagatoro is what true fear is made of. Okay, maybe I'm overreacting a bit. Let's see if episode 2 is any better, and it's even worse. For the love of God, this girl gets more horrifying with each passing second. Where are the teachers? Where is the principal? Where is anybody to save Senpai from this slow, painful torture? Senpai shakes at her mere presence. It's too much. She's about to straight murder him in episode 2. She gets her fangs out like a rabid dog and is ready to pounce. If it wasn't for the fact that Senpai himself was a disgusting degenerate, we'd have a major crime scene on our hands. The atmosphere is so dark and brooding. Why is it raining? It's always raining. They're trying to set a tone here. That tone being that we should be very afraid of what's to come. The thing that scares me most, though, is the fact that I can't look away. I keep watching this girl make this grown-ass Senpai suffer. He just keeps crying and losing it, and I'm sitting here with a tube of M&Ms watching it unfold for my entertainment. Maybe I am a fan of horror. No. That thought alone is what terrifies me the most. This is clearly a horrific, terrifying anime. But maybe it's because it took some liberties with the manga? I can't just call this thing a horror anime without reading the original source material. Maybe I'm missing something. So, like the senpai-es degenerate that I am, I ordered myself the first volume of the Nagatoro manga. Nope, still pretty mind-breaking. Have you ever seen somebody sip juice like that? Have you ever seen somebody even sip tomato juice? That in itself is a disgusting act. Pieces of media like this need to come with a warning. I wasn't prepared to see something like that. Don't Toy With Me Nagatoro is something that will keep me up at night for years to come. When death finally comes to retrieve me, I truly believe the face that I will see will be Nagatoro's. She truly is an eldritch horror.